Good evening and welcome to St. Michael's 2021 graduation ceremony. I'm your host, Miss Delamea, and I'm thrilled to be here today to celebrate our graduates of 2021 on this very special occasion. To begin, let's check out some of our grad trivia. Welcome back. I'm going to turn it over now to my co-host, Mr. Raposo, who's on the red carpet. Hello, Mr. Raposo.
Hey everyone, how's it going? Mr. Raposo here from our red carpet. I want to start off by saying thank you so much for the opportunity to do these interviews that you're going to see here from me on our red carpet. We're going to be speaking with a couple graduates, just like you, sitting at home. From various programs throughout our school, and we're going to learn about their experiences and maybe some of the things that they've learned throughout their 4 years here at St. Michael. So you'll see me throughout the show, and now we're going back to you in the studio. Mrs. Delamea?
We have a fabulous lineup for the St. Michael graduation ceremony. The ceremony will include speeches from our wonderful school administration and esteemed dignitaries and community members. Our graduation ceremony will begin with welcoming remarks from Mr. Tony Rosa, our Master of Ceremonies. O Canada will be performed by our St. Michael Grade 12 Ensemble. Opening prayer and land acknowledgement will be delivered by Ms. Tanya Vincent, our St. Michael Chaplain. Mr. Frank DeCosola, our school trustee, will deliver an address to our graduates, as well as an address from Ms. Sylvia Jones, our Member of Provincial Parliament, MPP, for Dufferin Caledon. Mr. Ferdinando Tantolo, our principal, will also deliver an address to our graduates. The reading of graduate names will be given by Ms. Jennifer Govea and Mr. Michael Pupo. The acknowledgement of award recipients will be delivered by Mr. Shaun Raposo. Our 2021 valedictorian, Mr. Shaun Sunil, will deliver his valedictorian address, followed by the 2021 Lib Dub by our 2021 graduating class. Our closing prayer for our ceremonies will be delivered by Father Andrew from Holy Family Parish in Bolton. This is Ms. Delamea coming to you from the MiCTV studios for the 2021 St. Michael graduation ceremony. Let's now go to a very special message for our graduates from our Vice Principal, Mr. Weatherby.
Congratulations to the graduates of 2021. We both started at St. Michael in the same year, and it's been a pleasure watching you grow and contribute to our school and Bolton community during this time. You're a special group of students, and your school spirit and Thunder pride has been unmatched over the past 4 years. The historic accomplishment of winning color wars in all 4 years will go down in school history. We are blessed to call you graduates of St. Michael Catholic Secondary School and know you will accomplish many great things as you enter the next chapter of your life. Thank you again for your resilience, and congratulations once again to the graduates of 2021.
If we can reflect back to September 5th, 2017, this day marked the first day of school for St. Michael Catholic Secondary in the small community of Bolton, Ontario. An eager, anxious group of grade 9s passed through the front doors of the school after the roar of the buses leave, marking a new beginning. As teachers and staff, we welcome these new students. All of these new faces that would soon help shape the identity of our school came into the building and, after 4 very short years, became part of the St. Michael history through their own contributions in sports, arts, academics, social justice, and faith, creating the wonderfully diverse, spirited, inclusive, and gifted space that we continue to call St. Michael today. Despite the challenges posed due to the pandemic, these resilient and dedicated students have left a lasting legacy for the future graduating classes of St. Michael. We celebrate them in all their glory today. On behalf of all the teachers and staff, as well as all future graduates, thank you, graduates of 2021, for all that you've brought to our school. And we wish you a lifetime of happiness as you embark on a new journey. Now, let's return to some interesting grad trivia. Let's go back now to Mr. Raposo on the red carpet. Mr. Raposo?
Thank you very much, Mrs. Della Maia. And now we'd like to start our first red carpet interview with Julia Supa. Julia, hello and welcome to the red carpet. How are you?
Hey, Mr. Raposo. I'm doing good, thanks. I can't believe we're already graduating.
So, Julia, I obviously said this before, you are a music student. And I guess the question here is, as a music student, obviously it's had a special part in your life. Tell me, what are some of the things that you've learned in music that have helped you to become a more successful student?
Being a music student has taught me so much, ranging from so many types of skills. Of course, I have a lot to say about this program, but I'm going to keep it short and sweet. In this program, I became successful in managing my time and working group settings. As most of you know, we have our annual showcase, but so much more goes on behind the scenes. We have competitions and our annual band trip. And so much hard work and dedication goes into every single piece that we perform. We get together weekly as a band or a choir for rehearsals to get to where we would like to be. Yes, it can get busy at times, but we have to work through it to reach our goal.
So obviously, Julia, today's your graduation day, but the big question here is, do you see yourself pursuing music after high school and into post-secondary?
I will not be studying music for post-secondary, but I will continue it as a hobby or in my free time. Even though I'm not studying music, I made so many friendships that I will bring with me after I graduate. I'm so thankful to be a part of this program, and I will cherish every single memory that I have made. I would like to thank Ms. Simba, Mr. Engson, and all my friends for making my high school experience so memorable.
Thank you so much, Julia, for your time today, and we wish you all the best as you graduate.
Thank you so much for having me.
The action's just getting started here on the red carpet during our graduation pre-show. We have a lot more action to come, but for now we hope that you enjoy one of our created baby videos that showcase what our graduates looked like when they were a lot younger. Stay tuned because there's more to come.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. Always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears, but never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye, but yesterday's gone. We gotta keep moving on. I'm so thankful for the moment, so glad.
Stay like that. Oh, darling, don't Don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up. It can stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you. Won't let no one break your heart. No, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. Never grow up. You're in the car on the way to the movies and you're mortified. Your mom's dropping you off. At 14, there's just so much you can't do and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too. And don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. And no one's ever burned you. Nothing's ever left you scarred. And even though you want to, just try to never grow up. Take pictures in your mind of your childhood room. Memorize what it sounded like when your dad gets home. Remember the footsteps, remember the words said, and all your little brother's favorite songs. I just realized everything I have is someday gonna be.
Thank you for watching our St. Michael graduation ceremony of 2021. Looking at these baby photos, it is amazing to realize how fast time can pass and how each pic already shows each student's character. Let's go back now to Mr. Raposo on the red carpet.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Delamea. Now I'd like to welcome another special guest to the red carpet, Sarah Rapole. Sarah, hello and welcome to the red carpet. How are you?
Hi, yeah, I'm very good, very excited. Thank you so much for having me.
So Sarah, you are a visual arts student. I guess our first question for you here is, there are obviously some younger St. Michael students in the audience watching today. What would you say to them about our visual art program here at St. Michael?
So I would definitely say that if art is something you enjoy, definitely take the program. It's a really great program to enhance your abilities, just learn what you can do, as well as having a fun time with people around you. You have great teachers who will help you along the way. I think it's definitely a great program to gain more experience and confidence in what you do, while also just having like a fun time in school doing something that you enjoy. It's also a great program if you plan on, you know, furthering your art career and taking it past high school. It's something good to have under your belt. But ultimately, if it's something that you enjoy doing, it's a great program just to have some hands-on experience and make your high school experience a little bit better doing something you enjoy.
Obviously, these programs require a lot of time and commitment. What's something that you've learned over your last 4 years here, specifically in visual arts, that you will always take with you?
Yeah, so I definitely have learned a lot of things. I learned to make sure to stay on task, make sure things don't pile up, try to get everything done, you know, according to your schedule so you don't fall behind. But also something that I've learned is to remember why you're doing something. So for me, because I'm in art, I remember like I'm doing this because I enjoy doing it. It's something more for me than for anybody. Like I enjoy doing it, I'm proud of what I do. And I think as soon as you remember like you're doing it because you enjoy it, it's less of a job and more just kind of a hobby, something you actually want to spend your time doing. So make sure to keep it fun at the same time and remembering why you're doing something and the reason behind it. I think that that's very important and I'll take that with me.
Thank you very much, Sarah. Those were some fantastic answers and we appreciate you taking the time to speak with us here on the red carpet.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure being interviewed.
Well, we hope you're still enjoying our graduation pre-show. There's still a lot more to come, so stay tuned. Don't go anywhere.
In that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe.
Now, let's turn to a top 10 list of advice for graduates. Number 1, believe in yourself. You are enough. Take every new challenge on as if it is an invitation to grow. Number 2, never stop dreaming. Even when it seems that this is just a cliche and nothing more, there should never be a time when you face a wall and stop thinking of new possibilities. Number 3, do what you love. What makes you feel like you? What makes your heart sing? Ask yourself these questions and feed your soul. Number 4, stay true to who you are. Yes, TikTok dances and social media may be fun, but it doesn't define you. Put your phone down and look up. Number 5, don't settle for mediocrity. We are all good at something, but what can make you great? Number 6, don't burn bridges. This is no trite statement. Life is definitely too short to hold on to grudges and carry the burden on your shoulders. Keep moving forward and positively. Number 7, live honestly and with integrity. You will always be cherished. Number 8, live with humility. Conceit and self-indulgence are never good looks for anyone. Number 9, love, respect, and forgive yourself. We all make mistakes. Actually, this is what makes us stronger. Acknowledge this in others as well. Your connections with others will be defined by how you view yourself. And number 10, love others openly and unconditionally. Our faith calls on us to have empathy for all. Move forward in life with compassion for others. All heartfelt words to remember for our new grads. And now, let's return to Mr. Raposo, who is on the red carpet ready to interview some exciting grads. Mr. Raposo?
Thank you very much, Mrs. Delamea. Now we'd like to welcome to the red carpet one of our Dance Arts Advantage students, Kate Nigro. Kate, how are you? Welcome to the red carpet.
Hi, Mr. Raposo, I'm doing well and so happy to be on the red carpet today.
So Kate, the first question we want to ask here today is, as a dance student, obviously you have some past experience with performing in front of live audiences, but this year we've kind of removed the audience and a lot of what you did in dance took place in a virtual, online, video recorded environment. What kind of challenge was that for you?
It was definitely a challenge. I've been a dancer for almost my whole life, so I'm always used to performing on the stage and practicing in the studio. So it was definitely a challenge, and I know not just for me, but it was a challenge for all of us having to adjust to being in an at-home setting and having to move around furniture and let family members know you were filming so no one would make any noise or come in the frame. But yeah, it was definitely a learning experience though, and I know that we tried to make the most of it despite the circumstances. It was not what we thought it would be like, but yeah, we tried to make the most of it.
Obviously, being a part of an Arts Advantage program created a lot of opportunities for you as a student to experience. And one big question that we have is, what is one memorable moment from the dance program that you will always take and keep with you?
My most memorable moments would probably have to be at competition or during our year-end shows, which we only got to do two of, so it was definitely an unfortunate circumstance. But yeah, going to comp in grade 9 and 10 was honestly amazing. It was so much fun, and I am a competitive dancer in my own studio, so I'm used to it, but doing it with my school friends was totally a different experience, and it was awesome. So I really miss that and how we didn't get to do that, but we did make the most of it with our virtual show this year. But other than that, like, my most memorable moments are honestly just being in the class, and just it would happen at the most random times, like just a something would happen. It's now just such a memorable moment to us, and that's just kind of where we build our friendships. And I met a lot of like cool people in there, and I'm definitely gonna be friends with them for years. So yeah, most memorable moments would probably be something that I didn't even expect to be something I would remember, if that makes sense.
Thank you very much, Kate. Unfortunately, this is all the time we have here on the red carpet, but we appreciate you taking some time to answer a few questions for us.
Yeah, for sure. Thank you so much for having me, Mr. Raposo.
And we hope you're still enjoying the pre-show for Thundergrad 2021. Now we'd like to share a special admin message from Mrs. Duke Kelly.
To the 2021 graduates, I wish you success and happiness as you continue your journey through life. I believe that we all should give back to our community. So please remember the words of Winston Churchill. We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. Be proud of who you are and where you came from, but never forget, it is better to give than receive. So congratulations to the graduating class of 2021.
I hope you are all enjoying the 2021 St. Michael Catholic Secondary School graduation ceremony show so far. We still have more great content to follow. So sit tight, relax, and enjoy more of what's to come. Let's go back now to Mr. Raposo, who's waiting on the red carpet.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Delamea. And now we're back here on the red carpet, and we're about to have an interview with Katerina Zenny. Katerina, how are you? Welcome to the red carpet.
Hey, sir. Thank you for having me.
Katerina, obviously being a part of a drama program here at St. Michael, drama holds a big place in your heart. How has being a drama student shaped you into the young lady you are today?
You know, being a part of drama, I got to work with a lot of people and teachers and take on a lot of characters and roles. And I think that through the classes, I got to express myself and grow both creatively and emotionally. And I feel like through taking on different characters and roles, I got to kind of live vicariously through the characters and experience what they experience. And I kind of learned from that as well and applied it to my own life.
Katerina, obviously, we can say tonight that there are some younger either St. Michael students or students that may be attending St. Michael in the future. What would you tell them about the Arts Advantage drama program?
The drama program, in one word, is just welcoming. In more words, it's fun. It's allows you to express yourself creatively. You form a bond with people through it. And I think that if anybody out there, younger students, are considering taking it, just do it. Even if you're taking the sciences or something else and you feel like you might not belong, it is the most welcoming program and you will have so much fun and you'll learn a lot. There's a lot of different things that you learn, like, there's so much that I honestly can't even say it off the top of my head, but I think you'll enjoy it, and I think that it'll be a nice break from all the tests in the lab, so.
Katerina, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us on your graduation day here on the red carpet.
All right, thank you so much for having me, Sarah. I'm really glad I got to be part of the red carpet tonight. Bye.
So we all still hope you're enjoying our red carpet interviews and our pre-show. Now we'd like to introduce another graduate baby video.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
Thank you all for watching our St. Michael graduation ceremony of 2021, coming to you from the MiCTV studios. Even though we are a part of this time, we're still connected through the celebration of our wonderful graduating class, who has showed such tenacity and devotion throughout. We honor you all. Stay tuned, because there's still more to come as we await the graduation ceremony for our 2021 grads to begin. Let's return now to Mr. Raposo, who has another great interview with an excited grad. Hello, Mr. Raposo.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Delaman. Now we'd like to invite Sarah Gully to the red carpet here for her interview. Sarah, hello and welcome. How are you?
Hey, sir. Yeah, I'm doing good. I'm excited that it's grad day. I'm a little nervous about graduating. I'm very afraid of whatever comes next after high school, but yeah, I'm doing good.
So Sarah, this year you had the interesting experience of being one of our lead student members of the LipDub. Obviously this experience had some challenges, but what's one specific experience you're going to take from this LipDub creation that will always stay with you?
So one of the biggest things that I learned while creating the LipDub is how long it really takes to do stuff. Like, I thought that we were going to be able to grind out the LipDub in like 2 weeks. I was like, yeah, we'll just get the videos, edit them together, easy peasy. Definitely not easy peasy. It took months of planning, months of creating. We had to get all the videos, we had to edit it, we had to edit all the clips together. Like, it was a lot more work than I thought. And the other thing that I really learned is that there is always like somebody else on the other end of the things that we're submitting that desperately needs us to submit things. Like, I sort of put stuff off and hand stuff in late. I don't think I'm ever gonna hand in an assignment late ever again. My poor teachers, you know? Like, we were sort of waiting for some videos and it was like, oh my God, like, we really need to get this stuff, like, we need to get this stuff moving and rolling. And it's just, yeah, like, there's always somebody else on the other end of everything that we're doing who needs us to get our stuff in. And the other, like, biggest takeaway from this is that we didn't think that we were gonna get a LipDub. We weren't sure, so we just planned it, you know? And it's like, wow, like, that's the power of like a good group of students. Like, we got this in, you know, like, we got this done. And we also got involved. Like, I'm never gonna look back on my high school experience and be like, oh, I wasn't involved in anything, or like, oh, we switched to online, so I just didn't do anything. Like, no, I planned the LipDub, you know? Like, it is just so great that we're all gonna have stuff like this to look back on and be like, wow, okay, like, we got involved in things.
Sarah, obviously this year you had the unique experience as well of being one of our morning broadcast hosts. Not something that everyone volunteers for, but it's something you did volunteer for. Not easy being on the camera, as we both are today. But question for you is, you know, what's something that you can share with the audience at home today about being the on-camera morning broadcast host? And do you see yourself pursuing anything with live on-camera work in the future?
So something that I can share about being the morning announcement host is how easy it is to slip up, especially when you're like live on camera, you know? Like, sometimes you watch the news or like live things and you're like, oh, those people, like, they just messed up, they don't know how to do their jobs. But it is so easy to read out the wrong date, which I've done before, or really poorly pronounce a word, which I've done so many times, or even like the amount of times that I've not realized that we were rolling and I'm just staring and smiling into the camera and like, oh my God, help me, so many times. And it's just one of those things that you kind of just need to brush off. Like, yeah, I look like a fool, but like, whatever, it's fine. And like, as for if I would want to like do something on camera, like as a career, right now I'm not really thinking. I have no idea what I'm gonna do in the future. But right now it's sort of like, I don't think so. Though if you had ever asked 12-year-old me what I thought my future career was going to be, 100% I would have said radio show host. I really thought I was going to be a radio show host. I thought that was going to be me. But like, for on camera, I don't think so. But if the opportunity arises for me to be on camera, who am I to say no to that?
Sarah, thank you very much for your time spent here on the red carpet.
Yeah, sir, and thank you so much for giving us the chance to do these interviews.
So we still have a few interviews here on the red carpet, but at this moment in time, I'd like to pass it back to our host, Mrs. Delamea, in the studio. Ms. Delamea?
Let us now turn to the principal of St. Michael's Secondary, Mr. Tantalo, for some important words to our graduates.
Hi, everyone. Just to say a few words on your successful graduation. So I'll start off with, if I had to do my grad quote, and it would look like this. If life were like a box of chocolate, you never know what you're gonna get. And that's been certainly what we've been having to deal with for this last year. And you know, if I was invited to do the lip dub, what would my dance look like? Well, my cameo for the lip dub, well, it would look like something like maybe this, a little dance. I'm happy and you know it, but I wasn't invited, so I won't spoil the fun. But on a serious note, as I reflect on farewell words to share with the grade 12 body and the graduating class, I'd like to share quotes of inspiration that have helped me in the past. And it's been passed on from people that have helped and helped me with decisions along the way. So one quote that was shared was, "Work to be a better version of yourself each day." The question is, can we be kinder each day? Can we be more generous each day? Can we be more empathetic each day to others? Are we able to hear someone else's perspective more each day? That is a challenge that I aim for myself, and that I hope that is something you can do for yourself as well. Another phrase, one that I've heard when I was younger, was from a biology teacher, and it was said like this: we eat, we breathe, we sleep, some longer than others. But what can we do that's different? The teacher was challenging us to dream, set goals, and work towards obtaining those goals. Both perspectives that I still keep with me today. So I wish, and I'll end with this, I wish the graduating class of 2021 well on your future endeavors. Stay positive, don't be afraid of failure. Failure is the key to learning. This is not a goodbye, but until next time, keep your thunder spirit wherever you go and keep faith at the center of your decisions. Be well.
Thank you for watching this year's celebration of the St. Michael graduating class of 2021. We turn back to Mr. Raposo on the red carpet for another exciting grad interview. Mr. Raposo?
Thank you very much, Mrs. Delamea. And now we're back here on the red carpet with Laura Alt. Laura, how are you today? Welcome to the red carpet.
I'm good, sir, and I'm glad to be here.
So Laura, obviously sport has contributed to a large portion of your high school experience here. What is one sport experience that will be staying with you that you will forever look back on as a very positive and strong memory here for you at St. Michael?
One experience that I'll never forget is when I was on the basketball team in grade 10. We were versing another school and we were down by like, I don't even know how many points. So I decided that I couldn't really make the score any worse for us, and I decided to shoot a three. I've never shot a three in a game before, so it was all new, and I was just hoping it would have missed by a mile. But to my complete surprise, it actually went right in, and I turned to my teammates on the bench with my jaw practically on the floor, just in complete shock. And of course, they were all happy and excited for me. It was my first three, and to make it even better, a couple minutes later, my teammate and now fellow graduate, Emily Simonetta, also got her first three in a game. And even though we lost, I'll never forget it. It was an amazing day.
So Laura, something that we know about you is obviously you are a member of our sport SHSM program, but maybe that's something people at home didn't know. What would you say as an SHSM student to anyone who's watching at home that might be considering joining one of our SHSM programs in the future?
If you're thinking about taking a Shizm course, my advice is just to do it. All the teachers in the different programs are amazing, and it's only going to make your high school experience better and more well-rounded. It has personally taught me more leadership skills and helped me break out of my shell. We had an overnight trip to Cedar Glen. We all got CPR certified, which is super important. If it sparks your interest, don't even hesitate to join, because I know you'll enjoy it.
Thank you very much for sharing that, and we also want to thank you for spending time with us here on the red carpet.
Thanks for having me, and I'm glad I could be a part of this.
Our graduation pre-show is still going here. Obviously, we still have a couple more interviews on the red carpet. But now we're going to continue on with the pre-show, and we hope you enjoy another one of our baby videos.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. Although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down. Always be found. Just know you're not alone.
pandemic, our dynamic and enthusiastic Thunder Student Council, led by the wonderful Miss Warner, has continued to bring the fun through a number of different initiatives with the help of social media. On the Instagram account of Thunder Council, graduating students Shaun Sunil, Maddie Kerrigan, and Kate Armstrong, along with the rest of Student Council, went above and beyond to help keep the Thunder spirit alive. With fun teacher Q&As, Spirit Wednesdays, polls, color wars, bingos, themed weeks, contests, and more. Student Council's annual Sick Kids also raised $18,000 after Canadian actor Ryan Reynolds and Samsung Canada doubled our school's contributions. Congrats to Shaun, Maddie, and Kate for their unforgettable and outstanding work and dedication in bringing the St. Mike's community together in spirit, especially during these trying times. We will miss you, and on behalf of students and staff, we wish you a future that is bright.
Now we have a special two-person interview coming up here on the red carpet. I'd like to welcome Kate Armstrong and Maddie Kerrigan. Kate, Maddie, how are you today, and welcome to the red carpet.
Hi, sir, we're both doing great.
Yeah, we're really excited to be graduating today.
So first question, obviously you are both members of Student Council, and Student Council this year especially has been a big part of the creation of school spirit here at our school and trying to keep that school spirit up. As members of Student Council, and one of you can answer, what is one event that will forever stick out in your mind as something memorable and you'll never forget as a fantastic Student Council high school experience?
That's a really good question, sir, and I think I'm gonna have to go with the most obvious answer, which is for sure Color Wars. There are so many amazing things about that event and getting to plan it, like seeing everyone in the school dressed up in their color as a grade and donating tons of toys and tons of money to such a great cause. And there was also the little things too, like taking the pictures on the stage in the calf and eating brownies together during period four after we won, which, you know, we've continued our win streak, which is an added bonus. And I think kind of from a Student Council perspective, it's a really important event to us because it was started by a council member and it's continued by council members. And we really love giving back to the community. And a few years ago, we were actually able to deliver the toys to said kids, which was just a great experience, such a great time, and actually being able to deliver the toys was such a great moment. And I'm definitely not gonna forget it.
So obviously being a member of Thunder Council requires leadership. How will the leadership experiences you've had over the last 4 years prepare you for life outside of high school and after you're done here at St. Michael?
Yeah, so I think that me and Kate use a lot of our leadership skills now to plan events and keep school spirit alive and kind of exactly what you think of when you hear Student Council. And it's something that we both love doing and something that I think we both want to do in university too. But leadership is also super useful on a day-to-day basis, both in and out of the classroom. So even something like working on a group project is somewhere where we can take the skills that we've learned and the lessons, like how to problem solve or how to take initiative and apply them. And I think that's going to be really useful going forward.
Kate and Maddie, thank you so much for those wonderful answers, and thank you so much for spending time with us here on the red carpet.
Bye, sir. Thanks for having us.
Bye, sir.
So there's still a little bit of time left here in our pre-show with another interview to come on our red carpet. But for the time being, here at MiCTV, we like to do something called the Question of the Week. And of course, today being graduation, we've decided to create a little video called our Grad Question of the Week. So we hope you enjoy.
Class of 2021, happy grad day! I'm actually coming to you neither live nor from the Matrix to ask our annual grad question. I asked a bunch of you guys three very good, very introspective questions on high school and our graduating class, and you guys did not fail to deliver. What was your most memorable moment of high school?
Hi grads, one of my most memorable moments of high
school was probably when I would organize my school's walkouts, rallies, and campaigns on topics such as Black Lives Matter, sexual assault in school, and missing and murdered Indigenous women. This was really important to me because it was my way of activism and to get people aware, motivated about the issues, and to make real change in the world.
One of my most memorable moments of high school is when we got evacuated during one of our exams.
Probably in grade 11 physics, we had to test our knowledge of projectile motion, and so we had a Nerf gun fight.
Probably winning grade 11 color wars.
My time on the basketball team in grade 10.
Grade 10 color wars, when we were taking the picture in front of the stage, it's just like so emotional and so nice to see everybody all gathered together in one spot, all united for such a good cause.
Question number two. If you could describe the graduating class in one word, what would it be?
If I could describe the graduating class in one word, it would be creative.
Competitive.
Would definitely have to be inspiring.
I would say collaborative.
Unity. It'll probably be energetic. I feel like we're always jumping headfirst into things with a positive attitude about it. And when we do something, we would go all in.
And question number three, which is my personal favorite. What St. Mike specific thing are you going to miss the most?
So to me, the most memorable thing about high school, and it's not a specific event, but it would be the outdoor patio of the CAF. Don't ask me why, but it was really nice, and no one ever went out there. I don't know why. It's a hidden gem, I guess, but in grade 9 and 10, me and my friends would spend almost every day out there until it got too cold. So, yeah, I'm gonna miss those red tables. Good memories.
I think I'll miss seeing everybody's socks, like, with our tucked-in pants every day, because that's, like, super cool.
Definitely not the profile cards that we had to do, because those were awful and tedious. Probably hearing the teachers in the halls, like in the morning and between class.
Probably getting an apple pie every day at lunch from the CAF.
The CAF poutine.
The poutine in the CAF.
I'm gonna miss seeing all the fully wrapped mortadella sandwiches that everyone just throws on the floor in the CAF at lunch.
When we had that breakfast thing in the grade 9 hallway.
The random clapping in the CAF at lunchtime.
Probably going to school, like, after weekend, seeing that my lock's been stolen for the third time in that year.
Arts Advantage drama.
Definitely the CAF cookies or the fries.
The AV club. I made lots of friends in AV. We did lots of fun projects too. And it was just like an extra chance to be like a little bit more creative, right?
The panic when you go back to your locker and the lock's been replaced with someone else's lock.
The class of 2021 has undergone a very unique high school experience. It is easy to say that through it all, we have remained resilient. This year was filled with many challenges and disappointments that we faced together as a class. Throughout it all, we kept our heads high and remained with the same spirit that we had all of high school. We entered St. Mike's on a high note and will definitely be leaving on the same note.
And that wraps up our grad question of the week. I want to give a big thank you to everybody who let me interview you. I very clearly could not have done this without you. And I also want you to know that the correct answer to the St. Mike's thing that you're gonna miss the most is the sandwiches on the floor in the hallway. Anyways, congrats to everybody who's graduating, and I hope you guys enjoy the rest of grad.
This year's valedictorian deserves distinct recognition. Throughout his 4 years at St. Mike's, he has consistently risen to the occasion through his dedication, resilience, integrity, and involvement. Through his incredible academic and school spirit commitment and beyond, Sean leaves a lasting legacy here at St. Michael. Let's head over to Mr. Raposo, who will speak to the outstanding grad himself. Mr. Raposo?
Thank you very much, Mrs. Delamea. Now we have a very special interview coming to you from our red carpet. We have our class valedictorian, Shaun Sunil. Shaun, welcome to the red carpet. How are you?
Hey, Mr. Raposo. Thank you for having me here today. I'm feeling great, and I'm so excited to be here on the red carpet today.
So, Shaun, obviously today is a very special day for the 2021 graduates. How do you feel as their valedictorian as you prepare to share your final grad speech with your graduating class?
Yeah, so it's such an honor to represent the graduating class of 2021 here today. And I do touch upon this in my speech, but I think as a class right now, we're feeling so many different emotions because we're sad as we reminisce on the memories we've created these past 4 years. And it feels almost as if the journey we've experienced together for so long now is finally coming to an end. But on the other hand, I do think a part of us is excited for the future and what comes next, because Especially for this class, the potential is so great that it feels as if the road ahead is filled with endless opportunities. So I think we're all just excited to move on to that next chapter and see what lies ahead.
So Sean, two questions here. The first one we want to know is obviously, you know, what's your favorite memory from your graduating class? But secondly, and hopefully without spoiling too much from your speech tonight, we just wanted to know, what advice would you give future or current St. Michael students as they work toward their graduation?
To answer your first question, I would say that my favorite high school memory that I got to experience with the rest of my class would be in our grade 11 year during Color Wars. We were in very close competition with the grade above us, and we really wanted to win that year because we had won the 2 years beforehand and we didn't want to taint our streak so that we had some sort of hope at a 4-year Color War win streak if we were to win the next year. So as we all eagerly waited by the PA to hear the results and they announced that we won, we were all so happy and we cheered, and it was such an accurate display of our class's spirit. And in that moment, it was cool because you would see everyone's perspective from their end on their Snapchat stories a few seconds after. So it really tied us all together in that way. And it felt like that high school moment you'd see in a movie. So that was a really cool moment to experience, especially all together with everyone in my class. But to answer your second question, I would say that my advice as I stand here today would be that high school is only as much as you make it. So come your graduation day, if you want to be satisfied with your experience, put yourself out there and join that extracurricular sports or club, or talk to that person you might not normally talk to because you might end up becoming really good friends in the end. But most importantly, show school spirit. And I think once you do all these things, come your graduation day, you'll be satisfied with your experience because you'll know that you took advantage of every opportunity high school had to offer you. So that would be my advice.
Sean, thank you very much for your time here on the red carpet, and we want to wish you all the best as you deliver your speech tonight as the valedictorian for your graduating class.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited for you all to hear my speech, and thank you for having me here today.
All right, so that's it from me here live on the red carpet. Once again, this is Mr. Raposo saying thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of this red carpet graduation pre-show experience. We still have the bulk of our show coming up, which is our graduation ceremony. But we are just about done the pre-show. We've put together a final year in review video for everyone to watch and enjoy. So right before graduation begins, we hope you enjoy this review video. Thank you very much. And this is it from me here on the red carpet. All the best.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Thank you.
As we prepare to begin with the rest of our graduation ceremony, this concludes our pre-grad show. On behalf of all the staff at MiCTV, my co-host Mr. Raposo and myself, we'd like to thank you for watching. We would like to send our warmest congratulations to the St. Michael graduates of 2021. Today is a new beginning. May this new beginning bring you all much happiness and success. And may you always bring the thunder wherever that thunder will take you. Have faith, show love, and be all that you were meant to be. We're all so very proud of you. Let's turn now to the celebration of St. Michael's graduating class of 2021.
Hello and welcome to the St. Michael Catholic Secondary School's 2021 virtual graduation ceremony. My name is Tony Rosa and I will be the Master of Ceremonies for this year's virtual graduation. On behalf of the St. Michael community, we would like to thank you for joining us to celebrate the successes of our graduating class. The 2021 graduates are a talented group of students who have a special connection to each other. It has been our pleasure to see them grow into young adults. With everything going on in the world today, we know this is not the end of your high school experience that any of us had envisioned. With our health and our strength in God, we know that we will get through this and come out stronger together. We hope that all of your experiences at St. Michael and over the past year will help to aid you in all your future endeavors. We ask that you please stand for the national anthem and the opening prayer, which will be read by Ms. Tanya Vincent.
We begin by acknowledging the land and our responsibility to care for and respect all that creation gives to provide us with life. This land upon which we live, work, and sustain ourselves is the ancestral and treaty lands of the Mishizagig Anishinaabek, also known today as the Mississaugas of the Credit, the rightful caretakers and title holders of this land. We also recognize that this land is rich in pre-contact history and relationships, which includes the Anishinaabek and Onkwehonwe, and since European contact has and continues to become home for Indigenous and non-Indigenous peoples. As a responsible community, we believe all people are sacred and possess inherent and immeasurable worth and dignity. Colonialism displaced and dispossessed Indigenous peoples of their ancestral lands and continues to deny their basic human rights, dignities, and freedoms. We are committed to the sacrament of reconciliation, making reparations, and fulfilling our treaty obligations, duties, and responsibilities as outlined in the Gudjunaganina Dish with One Spoon Wampum. This treaty governs and affirms that we actively maintain mutually beneficial relationships and collectively respect and care for the land, water, animals, and each other in order to guarantee a good life for our future descendants.
Thank you. As we begin our graduation ceremony, we consider the journey taken to this point as a school community and as individuals. Today, we celebrate what you, the graduates, have become at this moment in time, and we thank God for the gift of each of you, students of the 2021 graduating class of St. Michael Catholic Secondary School. Please join me in making the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, we praise you for your glory and thank you for your goodness to us. Look on these graduates with your love and bless them as they leave this school to move forward in life. May your Spirit give them many talents and skills and help them to use them for your glory and for the good of all people. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord. We also seek the intercession of our patron, St. Michael, as we pray our school prayer. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in our daily struggle to make wise decisions. Protect us from the temptation to hurt others, neglect ourselves, and deny our God. Stand by each member of this community as we grow in faith, discover our identity, and develop our God-given gifts. Grant us the courage to face our challenges, learn from our mistakes, celebrate our successes, and to reach our fullest potential. Guide us in our journey to be with God. Amen. St. Michael, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Tanya Vincent. Next, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our local Catholic trustee, Mr. Frank DiCosola. Mr. DiCosola is one of 11 elected community members who sit on the Dufferin-Peel Catholic District School Board. The primary role of a trustee is to develop policy, approve the board budget, address student achievement matters, and communicate with parents and guardians' concerns with a jurisdiction. Catholic school trustees are charged with maintaining and advancing the Catholic nature of our school system. I give you Mr. DiCosola, your Catholic school trustee for Caledon Dufferin.
Hi, my name is Frank DiCosola, and I am the school trustee for Caledon and Dufferin County. On behalf of our school community and myself, I want to congratulate all our graduates on your successful completion of your elementary or secondary education. Our community knows that these graduation ceremonies are not the same, and we hope that despite this temporary change, that you continue to pursue your dreams. As graduates, you have been resilient and focused, and we wish you the best in your next journey of life. Good luck, and God bless.
Thank you, Mr. DiCosola. I would like to bring greetings on behalf of Michael Brunetto and Marie Moran from the St. Michael Parent Council. Congratulations to the graduates and best wishes for the future. Next, I would like to introduce Ms. Sylvia Jones, MPP for Dufferin-Caledon.
Hello, I'm Sylvia Jones, your Member of Provincial Parliament for Dufferin-Caledon. To all the graduates in 2021, well done and congratulations. I know that this pandemic has changed the way you have hoped to commemorate your educational achievements, but you also need to celebrate. You've worked hard, and we recognize all that you have accomplished. I offer my very best to every graduate, and good luck in your future endeavors. Stay safe.
Thank you, Ms. Jones. We are now happy to have our principal, Mr. Tantalo, share a few words with the St. Michael class of 2021.
Hi, class of 2021. I want to first congratulate you on your remarkable achievement, successfully graduating from high school, one of many landmark moments in your life journey. Your high school journey began in grade 9 with renewed energy and with youthful innocence. Now, having completed grade 12, your high school journey has now ended. We hope you are leaving with 4 years of growth, maturity, resiliency and faith. We hope that St. Michael's was a place of connection where friendships made will last eternal. A place where you choose a pathway that will lead you to your career passion, and a place where fond memories will stay with you everywhere you go. This past year was challenging. You have endured school closures. You have dealt with much uncertainty. You have become virtual experts, experiencing a new way of learning. You are the first to experience Zoom fatigue. With such unique experiences, we hope that this has made you more resilient, more appreciative, and more empathetic of others. Without staff and students, school is but a mere brick and mortar structure that may be appealing on the outside, but complete emptiness on the inside. I think we have all struggled through this global pandemic, but we know those who have suffered more. We keep those in our prayers. This too shall pass, and we'd only be stronger for it. If nothing else, it should teach us how to take care of ourselves, keeping well-being close. Stay grounded in our faith. To be faithful is a glue that keeps us strong. Focus on morality. Continue to eradicate hate, racism, and keep advocacy at the forefront of your heart. Be passionate and have a purpose and voice. We are all intelligent people, but ignorance stalls intelligence. We are products of a Catholic education who are now advocates. The common good is our beacon as we continue through our untraveled path. I remember the time I began at St. Michael's. I remember the chatter, the energy, the community, and the joy of the student body. I can't lie, I did have a hard time with students tucking their socks in their pants. I was told it was a Caledon thing. I eventually got over it. Remember to nourish three things at each opportunity. Your mind, continue to strengthen this as it is your compass. Your body, nourishing it properly is vital for continual energy. Your spirituality, it helps you in good times and bad. Finally, stay true to yourself. Live life faithfully. Please don't be afraid to fail. Hug your parents, guardians, and say thank you to your teachers. Don't forget to cheer your friends. Life is an ongoing journey of learning. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. Good luck and be well.
Thank you, Mr. Tantalo. It is important to recognize two very special groups of people who have supported the graduates and prepared them for this day. Graduates, over the past 4 years, your teachers, support staff, and administrators have challenged you, listened to your needs, and motivated you to always do the best and reach for your fullest potential. Thank you to all of our teachers, support staff, and administrators for all you have done to support the graduating class. The other group of people that we must recognize this evening are your parents and guardians. They have supported you, loved you unconditionally, and have complete faith in you as you work so hard to reach this milestone. We ask all of you graduates to say thank you to your parents, guardians, and family members who have supported you in the past 4 years and will continue to support you in all your future endeavors. We welcome Ms. Govea and Mr. Pupo to now read the names of the St. Michael graduating class of 2021.
Good evening. My name is Ms. Govea, and I will be reading names A through K.
Christian Abatino Kelman, Sophia Agostino, Lara Alt, Felicia Amelio, Eva Amodio, Lucas Arena, Marcus Arena, Christina Ariganello, Antonio Armada, Isabella Armada, Kate Armstrong, Caterina Arone, Peter Arsenault, Gabriel Arshad, Michael Asta, Vincent Atamosa, Massimo Attardi, Nicholas Osiello, Hannah Belise, Brennan Bandera, Matteo Barbieri, Chase Barron, Giuliano Basile, Nicholas Basile, Justine Besant, Julia Beamish, Julia Berardi, Justin Bifolci, Ryan Bokla, Miguel Botello, Anthony Botoni, Arianna Burrell, Anthony Burton, Emma Bush, Carmen Calla, Dominic Calamino, Claudia Camilleri, Carly Campbell, Maria Candido, Isabella Canzio, Matteo Cappadocia, Michael Capello, Valentina Caridi, Alessia Carpanzano, Maya Cascalar, Rio Cassano, Vero Cassano, Carlos Castro, Serena Cavalier, Lucas Cavallo, Massimo Cavallo, Claudio Cerone, Giancarlo Cesario, Alicia Chung, Abby Chisholm, Apolline Coutrier, Maria Kofa, Stefano Camiso, Alexander Conte, Jessica Cordy, Sierra Corzado, Daniela Costantini, Sophie Crane, Alexa Dakers, Sofia Dal Grande, Mariana D'Ambrosio, Donato Dorazio, Alexander Daniele, Joshua DuPont, Nico De Chiantis, Xavier De Donato, Vito De Pasqua, Isabella De Santis, Isabella De Bartolo, Christian Delgado, Christian Della Penna, Julia Della Mora, Adriano De Luca, Roman D'Amelio, Anthony DeRose, Massimo Di Nardo, Michele Di Pasquale, Michael Di Bari, Michael Di Dio, Samantha Di Gennaro, Karina Di Lorenzo, Luke Doran, Mark Dotto, Alex Dragone, Camille Denisky, Nikki Eden, Alexa Edger, Victoria English, Rocco Falvo, Emma Falvo, Emma Fanara, Sydney Farnsworth, Ava Fazzari, Bianca Federico, Annalisa Ferlisi, Daniel Ferlisi, Julia Figuera, Alessio Figueiredo, Maximo Figueroa Ilario, Serena Franchi, Emma Franco, Mariangela Fuoco, Matthew Fuoco, Mia Gabrielli Toffoli, Loreto Gagliardi, Sofia Garofalo, Jarek Peter Gindap, Jaden Gismondi, Joshua Giulianelli, Jack Goodman, Maya Grassa, Lauren Gray, Jacob Greco, Jonathan Greco, Mark Greco, Sophia Greco, Vanessa Greco, Brendan Gregg, Samantha Grieco, Veronica Guglietti, Samantha Gully, Sarah Gully, Shemaya Hawthorne, Michael Yaboni, Sofia Iacovelli, Marco Iozzo, Nicholas Johnny, Alessia Keats, Maddie Kerrigan, Adam Kahn, Tyler Kirkland, Annika Klausman, Hayden Knight, Kritzia Krajowski Hernandez.
Good evening, I'm Mr. Pupo, and I'll be reading names L through Z. Mia Leggeri, Julian Lepiane, Sabrina Lera, Alessandro Letieri, Gabriella Libertella, Giulia Lizzozzi, Noah Longo, Joseph Lequercio, Jordan Maliaro, Ava Malatesta, Nancy Martinez, Daniel Martini, Nicola Martino, Paul Martino, Ryan Mardo, Michael Mauro, Matthew McCauley, Aiden McCulloch, Frank Anthony Marola, Dante McCauley, Sebastian Mignella, Julia Minna, Samantha Molella, Anna Moncayo Ortega, Vito Montagnese, Jenna Moore, William Moran, Rocky Mora, Julian Mossini, Katarina Narain, Kiana Nemi, Selena Neshi, Haley Nicholson, Kate Nigro, Holly Norris, Daniel Nualda, Vincent Opidisano, Christina Orbe, Kyle Piccini, Dominic Paliuca, Sebastian Palicrucis, Martina Pania, Alexandra Parnaby, Emma Perry, Dylan Pichinen, Jacob Pichinen, Julian Piloli, Alex Pingitore, Damian Perez, Andrew Pleasance, Martina Porquette, Julia Peretta, Natalie Prete, Melania Prezano, Michael Provado, Quentin Race, Maya Rachele, Nicole Rachele, Daniel Razzo, Jennifer Rakajic, Sarah Ripoli, Samantha Rija, Sierra Ritaka, Madeline Ritlop, Michael Rivney, Gianluca Rizzo, Julia Rodriguez, Dominic Rolo, Julia Rosa Gastaldo, Jacob Rossi, Michael Rotella, Shane Rowe, Claudia Russo, Mario Russo, Malak Sabah, Anna Said, Antonio Salatino, Brianna Salmon, Nicholas Scarfo, Joshua Shenna, Emma Sherbo, Isabella Chambry, Jacob Schitzner, Sierra Scucciamari, Christian Senna, Brandon Shivdat,
Dante Shoje, Tristan Shoje, Emily Simonetta, Joseph Cito, Claudia Sobara, Sofia Spadafora, Nicole Spalvieri, Robert Spelko, Vincent Spina, Jenna Stumpo, Nicholas Sturick, Emily Sumeria, Shaun Sunil, Katarina Supa, Julia Supa, Anthony Siriani, Alessandra Talenka, Daniel Tanal, Emma Tertalia, Ethan Torin Baggio, Pia Tenoso, Matthew Termimi, Joshua Thomas, Angelina Thorne, Anthony Tobin, Hannah Tomasella, Alexandria Tomasevich, Danielle Tucci, Victoria Tuppen, Nicholas Uru, Alan Orteco, Benjamin Valverde, Jada Venturo, Antonio Vespier, Maria Villani, Evander Villeneuve, Olivia Vuel, Natasha Vidi, Alessia Vuro, Aiden Winslow, Katarina Zeni, Juliana Zinn, Julian Zito, Ariana Zua.
That concludes the reading of the names of the class of 2021.
Hello, my name is Mr. Raposo, and now we will be honoring the achievements of our graduates through the presentation of the St. Michael Departmental Excellence Awards and the 2021 Graduation Awards. The Excellence in Science Award is presented to a science student who has demonstrated excellence in at least two areas of science, biology, chemistry, or physics, and is pursuing a science-related program at the post-secondary level. This student has demonstrated passion, commitment, and dedication throughout high school. The recipients of this award are Lauren Gray and Alexandra Parnaby. The Excellence in Mathematics Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated excellence in mathematics, successfully completing multiple senior-level mathematics courses. The recipient of this award is Matta Carrigan. The Excellence in Business Award is presented to a student who has a keen interest in the world of business both inside and outside the classroom. The student demonstrates strong academic success in business classes, participates in business-oriented extracurricular activities, and appreciates the importance and scope of business in society. The recipient of this award is Shaun Sunil. The Excellence in English Award is presented to a student who demonstrates excellence and aptitude in studies in English. This candidate has taken two grade 12 English courses and demonstrates a command of the study of English literature and possesses excellent written and oral communication skills. The recipient of this award is Mario Russo. The Excellence in Moderns Award is presented to a student who demonstrates commitment and excellence in modern languages. This student exudes a true love and passion and appreciation for French language and for its culture. The recipient of this award is Apolline Cotria. The Excellence in Theology Award is presented to a student who has achieved a high academic average in multiple senior level theology courses and is a role model who makes a positive contribution to the St. Michael community. The recipient of this award is Shemaiah Hawthorne. The Excellence in Planning for Independence Award is presented to three graduating students who have shown leadership, perseverance, enthusiasm, and growth, both socially and emotionally. These students have made a positive contribution to the St. Michael community. The recipients of this award are Dominic Calamino, Madeline Ritlop, and Maria Candido. The Excellence in Arts Award is presented to a student who demonstrates commitment and excellence in the arts and has successfully completed multiple senior arts credits. This student is an advocate for arts in the school community, and the recipient plans to pursue further studies in the arts in post-secondary. The recipient of this award is Alicia Chung. The Excellence in Technological Studies is presented to a student who demonstrates commitment and excellence in the area of technological education and has successfully completed multiple technological education credits. This individual demonstrates leadership in the school community, involvement in extracurricular activities, and a high degree of skill with regards to industry standard practice. The recipient plans to pursue further studies or training in the area of technological studies. The recipient of this award is Martina Porquet. The Excellence in Physical Education Award is presented to a male and female student who demonstrate commitment and excellence in health and physical education. These candidates are positive ambassadors for the St. Michael community, display good sportsmanship, and model gospel values on and off the playing field. The recipients of this award are Matthew McCauley and Laura Alt. The Excellence in Social Science. This award is presented to a student who demonstrates commitment and excellence in social science and the humanities and Canadian and World Studies. She plans to pursue further studies in post-secondary in the subject area. The recipient of this award is Sarah Gully. That now concludes the reading of the Departmental Awards of Excellence, and we will now move on to the 2021 Graduation Awards. The Rotary Club of Palgrave Memorial Award is presented to a male and female student who demonstrate a commitment to academic achievement and are involved in a variety of school activities. These students plan to pursue their studies at the university level. The recipients of this award are Mario Russo and Sarah Gully. The Father Henk Vandenberg Scholarship Award is sponsored by the Knights of Columbus of Holy Family Parish. This award is given to a student who is a parishioner of Holy Family Parish. This student demonstrates a commitment to academic achievement, demonstrates outstanding leadership qualities, and makes significant volunteer contributions to the community. The recipient of this award is Danielle Tucci. Principal's Award is sponsored by R.J. McCarthy and is presented to a female and a male student who in their fourth year of high school have been instrumental in promoting a positive school spirit and a genuine love for their community. These students share their gifts and talents and participate in all aspects of school life. The recipients of this award are Kate Armstrong and Shaun Sunil. The Thomas J. Riley Scholarship is sponsored by the Dufferin-Peel Catholic District School Board. This award is presented to a graduating student who has demonstrated excellence in the study of a modern language and intends to pursue post-secondary education. The recipient of this award is Frank Anthony Marola. The Ed King Memorial Award. This award honors the memory of Ed King, a former principal with Dufferin Peel. This award is presented to a graduating student who has been actively involved in the school and community, especially in the areas that reflect our Catholic faith and concern for others. The recipient of this award is Brennan Bandera. The Catholic Leadership Award is sponsored by the Dufferin Peel Catholic District School Board. This award is presented to a graduating student who demonstrates a commitment to academic achievement, strong Catholic leadership, and best exemplifies the Catholic school philosophy. The recipient of this award is Samantha Malala. The Bishop Oscar Romero Award is sponsored by the Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association. This award is presented to a student who promotes social justice, challenges the status quo for improving the human condition, and demonstrates conviction through action. This student promotes community involvement by increasing awareness of social justice issues. The recipient of this award is Massimo DiNardo. This now concludes the presentation of the St. Michael Departmental Awards of Excellence and the 2021 Graduation Awards.
It is now time to introduce this year's valedictorian. This spring, our graduates selected their valedictorian. This student demonstrates true leadership and exemplifies the motto of our school, "Who is with God?" It is our pleasure to introduce you to graduate Shaun Sunil.
A warm welcome to all friends, family, staff, and honored guests, but most importantly, to the St. Michael's graduating class of 2021. For those of you who don't know, my name is Shaun Sunil, and I'm honored to represent this year's remarkable cohort of graduates. Now, where to begin is the question, because it's not like I can stand here and say that our high school experience was conventional. If anything, it was far from what we expected. With the many surprise twists and turns, it's kind of hard to encompass these past 4 years. But if I were to sum up our time here at St. Michael's, I'd start off by quoting the famous line by musician Tom Cochran, "Life is a highway." It feels as though we've heard this cliche line our whole life, and alone it does sound like a vague claim. But if we were to really dig deep and see life truly as a highway, what does that make us? I like to think that we would be the cars on the road, and each mile we take commemorates a milestone in our life and the legacy we leave behind. Now, have you ever experienced that new car scent? Whether you love it or hate it, something about it is so memorable, and it's because we associate that scent with opportunity. Walking through those big doors on the first day of grade 9, it was as if all you could smell was that new car scent, because as grade 9s, we were excited to finally embark on a new journey, high school. As we stepped into the matrix of St. Mike's, everything seemed so big, we felt so small, but really, it was because it was all new. New classmates, new teachers, new school, new system. Like all the unfamiliar features of a new car, it took time for us to familiarize ourselves with what we didn't know and get the hang of things. So we had to learn the hard way which hallways to avoid between period 1 and 2 if you wanted to get to class on time. I mean, personally, it took me a while before I realized that classes starting with the number 1 happened to be on the ground floor and 2 were up on the second floor. Now, had I realized that before, I probably wouldn't have been late to science class on my first day as I walked aimlessly on the first floor looking for room 217. However, with time and after many similar mistakes, we finally learned how our new cars worked, and we felt confident enough to drive on our own. As we coasted through high school, we began stepping outside of our comfort zone and changing lanes until we felt comfortable on the track we were on. So some found their place on a sports team and others pursued a passion in the arts. But regardless of who you were and what you did, our triumphs were celebrated together. The beauty in our story is that we not only accepted each other's differences, we embraced them. In every OFSA victory, art showcase, film festival, or extracurricular venture, we showed up with pride, passion, and commitment. And it's these qualities which motivated us to continue to strive for excellence amidst uncertainty. This past year, we've not just survived grade 12, we thrived amidst a global pandemic. We didn't allow this physical disconnect to break apart the foundation which we've spent the past 4 years establishing. Yes, the journey to this point turned out to be much different than we originally planned, since now we had to drive windows up and about 6 feet apart, but like always, we adapted. It was not by luck that we won Color Wars in previous years. Rather, it was our tremendous unity and spirit which motivated us to join together for a good cause. So, despite the distance this year, we were still able to unify together and finish off on a 4-year Color War win streak, going down in school history as the first class to ever do so. Today, we may not get to walk down that stage or throw our caps in the air or even finish off the smile as we had planned, but that doesn't discredit the laughs, memories, and accomplishments we've shared thus far. Looking back at the road we've driven these past 4 years, take a moment and applaud yourself for how far you've come. Many like to say, it's not the destination, it's the journey. And I think today we really understand what this means. If 4 years ago I walked into grade 9 only focused on reaching this milestone, I would have never stopped to appreciate the view that this ride had to offer. I would have never stopped to meet some of my closest friends, partake in spirit events, and truly value these past 4 years. Reflecting on this, we've grown to appreciate each other's company and value the importance of those around us, especially those who've been along for the ride. This great accomplishment, which we share here today, would not be possible without the help from our teachers and administrators. Thank you for teaching us to not only be better academics, but for being there to listen to us, give us advice, and instilling in us the confidence and determination to chase after our wildest dreams. Thank you to our parents and family members, bound by either blood or love, for not crushing said dreams and always supporting us. Although it feels as if it was just yesterday that you were helping us as we struggled to learn basic math at the dining table, we're forever grateful for all the time you've sacrificed for us and the wisdom you've shared to help us reach this point. Finally, I'd like to thank God for being a beacon of light when times felt uncertain, when we lost our path, strayed from our direction, or even took the wrong exit. It is with His unfailing love and support that we stand here today in celebration. I'd also like to give a quick special shout out to Zoom and Google Meet for keeping us alert and ready to constantly check if our mics are accidentally unmuted during class. I hope we can all continue to be this vigilant in our future endeavors. However, in all seriousness, without these passengers rooting for us from the back seat, this joyous occasion would not be possible. The memories we've shared together will bond us for a lifetime, and although the future can seem daunting and uncertain, we know we're equipped and ready. The tire tracks we leave behind here today are not simply signs of our existence. Rather, they're signs of our presence and the legacy we leave. Each track is different and each memory is unique, so it's nearly impossible for me to sum up each and every aspect of this journey. But what I can say in confidence is that as a group of talented, unique, and driven individuals, we did not let ourselves be judged by the struggles we faced. Rather, we demanded to be defined for our perseverance. Let us not be known as the class who was pitied for their losses. Instead, let us be remembered as the individuals who did not back down in the face of adversity. Our response to these challenges has enabled us to persevere past the unknown, and I'm certain that this attitude will not be left behind as we venture on ahead towards success. I can't say my route on this journey has been the same as yours, but it's safe to say that it is our diverse passions and ambitions which make our journey ahead that much more exciting. Therefore, as we end this mile and begin anew, let us remember that success is more than just wealth and status, but rather it's measured from the impact we leave on those we encounter along the way. Never forget that life is a highway. So as we each drive forward, may we continue to always be just as eager as we were way back in grade 9 and as resilient as we've learned to be in grade 12. The future for this class is looking more than bright, and the road ahead is filled with endless opportunities. But let us never forget how we felt when we first experienced that new car scent. Let us never forget the jokes we've shared in the CAF, the friends we've made in our classes, and the stories we've created here at St. Michael. So, from the bottom of my heart, I wish you all well, and thank you for these amazing past 4 years. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. We did it. Now, please join me as we premiere the 2021 Lip Dub.
Where is everyone?
Sean, haven't you heard? We're all in Cohort C now. Come join the call. The class is about to begin.
When everybody's words got in the way.
you gotta say.
We now welcome Father Andrew from Holy Family Parish to lead us in a closing prayer and offer a blessing to our graduating class.
My dear friends, congratulations. This is your graduation day. We can say this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. So we rejoice with you in many different ways, with your families, with your parents, your siblings, your friends, but also community, our faith community too, Holy Family Parish. You know, we've been connected with St. Michael's community in so many ways. And we were journeying together and we were praying at so many masses and so many events. And lately too, even we couldn't physically celebrate the mass together. We were always united in prayer. And this is so important because that unity will remain. You know, you're graduating today, but the unity of faith will remain. And that's our blessing and prayer for you. You know, that you always have that faith in your heart, faith that will remind you that you are God's children, God's beloved children. We are all children of God, right? God loves us. He's with us. And then when we believe this, we can do great things in this life. We can see where the Spirit leads us and what we can accomplish in this life. So let me say this prayer for you as you are graduating today. Before you were even formed, God knew you. While in your mother's womb, God named you. At your birth, God's breath filled you with life. Today we celebrate what you have become at this moment in time. And so we pray. God of our beginnings, we thank you for the gifts of these graduates, their excitement, their awesome wonder and curiosity, their open speech and encouraging word, their contribution have blessed us and challenged us, and we have become a richer and more diverse community because of them. As they step forward into the world that awaits, comfort their fears with the full knowledge of your divine presence. Strengthen their resolve to walk in the footsteps of Jesus as modern-day disciples in a world that needs their spirit. guide their feet as they move through life, protecting them from the pitfalls of darkness, while they help to lead future generations into the warmth and promise of your light. We ask this blessing upon each of them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations. God bless you.
From all the staff at St. Michael Catholic Secondary School, we wish you all the best for the future. Our dear graduates, remember the words of St. Catherine of Siena, who said, "Be who you were created to be, and you will set the world on fire." Congratulations, class of 2021. All the best.
Take it. Sometimes I just can't take it, and it isn't alright. I'm not gonna make it. And I think my shoes untied. I'm like a broken record. I'm like a broken record, and I'm not playing right. Just let it go, I'll bite, kill me. Till you tell me on the heavenly phone. So hold tight. Come on. To let you know that you've got a higher power. Got me singing every second, dancing every hour. Oh yeah. You've got a higher power, and she really someone I wanna know. Electric. This boy is electric, and you're sparkling like the universe connected. And I'm buzzing night after night after night. This joy is electric. This joy is electric, and you're circuiting through. I'm so happy that I'm alive. Happy I'm alive at the same time as you. Cause you've got a higher power. Got me singing every second.